Hi. In this video, we'll talk about some of the basic stuff related to database administration. In this video, we'll check how to log into a server, how to take a session, how to log into a SQL prompt, some of the basic OS commands like copy, move, df, ls, all these kind of commands which a database administrator take into account on a daily basis to carry out his work. Okay, so first thing is, like, on the screen you can see this is a putty. Putty is actually a medium through which we can take session to a server where our database are running. So okay, this is the IP of my server on which we'll be looking at. Okay, so I will press open. Let me set this screen. Let me just quickly adjust this to a capture screen so that we can have a good look to the session. Okay, seems perfect now. Okay, so now it is asking me to log in with a user. So I am having my OS user as Oracle. Okay, now it will prompt me for a password. It will ask me for the password. Let me quickly type the password. Okay, now we are on to the server. The first thing after logging to the server, ID will show you from which OS user you are logging. Here my user is Oracle, its group is DBA. Okay, and UID is the user ID, GID is a group ID. Okay, now ps space minus ef pipe grep space minus I will type pmon. Okay, from pmon I can check which pmon is actually a background process for a database. We'll make a separate session, separate video for this, all these background processes for a database. In this particular session we are just concentrating on how to accessing a server, how to just log into a server, how to check which services are running on this server, related to the database, and how to execute some of the basic OS commands. This is the motive of this particular session. This is just for the basic beginning. Okay, so another is, I just press the up arrow key and I just type a TNS to check for the listener in on a server. Basically we run two type of services, one is for the database and another is for the listener. Okay, so now we can see we are having one database that is named as db.org and we are having one listener running on this server, which is listener underscore db.org is the listener name. Okay, so now our next step is to take SQL plus session for this particular database, for which we have to type SQL plus. When I type SQL plus, it is showing me command not found. That means we have to set the environment for this particular database. Then only we will be able to take the SQL plus session. So now how to take that SQL plus session? We have to export the Oracle home, export the database name and set the path. So how to know what is the Oracle home location for this database? That database name is db.org. So we'll go to /etc/oratab. So oratab is a file basically which contains db home location, database home location for the databases. So this is our database and this is its home location. So our next step is to set the environment. So what we'll do, export Oracle home, Oracle underscore home is equal to this one, export Oracle underscore SID, or SID is database name is this one, and then export path is equal to dollar Oracle home /bin:\path. Okay, so we have set the path. So now we'll again type SQL plus. Yep. Now we got the prompt. Okay, and now we are onto the server SQL plus session. We'll exit and we'll type which SQL plus. SQL plus is basically executable which is being called from up to this path is our Oracle home, and this is the bin directory under Oracle Home, and this is the executable. So this was our Oracle Home, and this executable is calling from bin. Actually bin is a directory which is located under Oracle Home, which contains all the executables. So we check first executable, that was SQL plus, which is used to take the SQL plus session for the database. Now we'll check for the lsnrctl. This is the executable for the listener. We'll do status, and what was our listener name? The listener name we just checked earlier was this one. We just copy and we just paste. Here we go. We check the status. Okay, clear is another command which just clear your screen, and we just check how to set the environment, how to take SQL plus session. Okay, so now we move on to some of the other basic OS command, that is cd. Cd is for the change directory. Okay, I will do cd user1. User1 is one of my location onto the server. Okay, so if I do pwd, pw is the present working directory. So presently I'm located at user1 because I just changed the directory earlier. Okay, so if I press simply cd and press enter, it will take me to the home location of this particular OS from which we are logging. What is the home location of this OS user? That is /home/oracle. Okay, so another is cd space minus. It will send me to the previous location. My previous location was user1, and again if I will type cd space minus, it will again to the, it will keep on shifting me between the last two locations. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to check the another command, that is df space minus h. It will give me detail of the mount points on this particular server, the total size of the mount point, the used size and the leftover, and the percentage used for this particular mount point. Okay, so let's now go to user1, and we'll do ls. Ls is for the list, and to make it more simplified, we'll do ls space minus lrth. What it will do, it will give me the more simplified in-depth detail of the directories or files which are listed under this particular location. Now I can see earlier it just showed me the name, simply the names, but after doing ls minus lrth, it showed me the who is the owner of the file or the directory, and what is the size, and on which date it was created or last updated. Okay, now let's go to backup. In backup, let's check what is there. We are having arm and an export. I will type arm and I will check. We are having a couple of directories over there. Okay, so our next command is du minus sh. What it will do, it will give me the size of that particular file or a directory. So now here test1 is my directory. So if I will do du hyphen sh space test, what I will do, it will give me the size, and the size of this directory is 483 m, and I want to check size of file. I can simply again write du space minus h and just type the file name, and this is 20k, means kb. Now I don't want to do all this thing one by one. Now what I can do, I can put star. What I will do, it will calculate size of all the files of directory located under this location, and it will just show me the particular size. Okay, great. So next, let's jump to the next OS command. We'll check the next OS command, that is cp. Cp is to copy. Okay, okay, let's go to test1. Under test1, okay, I can see there are number of files over there. Okay, what we'll do, let's just copy cp this last one dot log file to a location I want to copy, or simply if I want to make another copy of this file, what I can do, I will do cp the file name space and the new file name what I want to give. I want to take it as a bkp, means I just want to backup it. I will press this. Okay, so now let's check whether it is created or not. Yep, we can see in this a copy of this file is being created, and the timestamp is this 3rd of September. So how to check the time of the server? We can simply type date. what it will show, it will show us the day, month, date and the time, and this is the time zone and the year. Okay, so now another command is move, mv. If I want to rename, okay, suppose I want to rename this file to something like, okay, I want to something like renamed underscore file dot txt. I want to change this file, I want to change the name of this file to this one. So I will do like this way. Okay, okay, before pressing enter, let's check. Okay, earlier we are having this one, and so bkp, so we are having this one, but we just recently renamed this one to this mv from move this file. So we just moved, and now see that name is changed to this one, and here it is. Okay, so cool. So our let's jump to another OS command, that is what we will check, that is top. Top is to check status of a server in terms of a load average, the CPU utilized and the memory available and free onto the server. If you type top, this command will keep on running until and unless you just press control plus C, means cancel. Okay, it will keep on executing. Okay, so now we are at, once I press CD it takes me to the home directory of this OS user from which we are logging, and what is it, is it is this. So okay, another one is ls space minus la. La will show you the hidden files. Those hidden files generally start with dot and the file name. Okay, so where we are this location. If I type ls space lrth, we can say we are just saying only limited output, but when I type ls-la, it will also show me the hidden files. So one such hidden file which is present at particular OS user home directory from which you are logging, that is .bash_profile. Okay, yeah, here it is. So what is the content? cat is to just check the content of the file. In this file we can see there is some of the content. Now when we earlier logged to this server and we were trying to take SQL session and it denied us because it's a command not found, then what we did, we set couple of parameters, environment parameters, just to take the SQL press session. So now what I will do, take a copy of this one, and we'll jump to this file vi editor is to edit any file. So now earlier we just cat this file, cat means to show the content, whole content of the file. Now vi is to edit this file, bash any file, not this file, any file we can edit. Okay, we are in vi editor now. If I press I, then it will allow me to type, and if I press escape, it will not allow me to type. So okay, we just copy all the export thing, and I will press escape colon wq and exclamation mark. Okay, it will save this file. Okay, so earlier what was the, we were having limited content under this file. Okay, so now we'll check that now we are having this, because we just entered this, we edited this file and we just put it this entries. So what is the purpose of this bash profile file, is hidden file, is whenever we log in from any particular OS user under which this file is present, this file automatically executes whenever we log in from that particular OS, and when it execute, it will execute all the content which is there inside that file. Now we just copied this content inside this file, so next time when we log in, or if we want to execute this file now also, then what we have to do, dot space and the file name, and file name is dot bash underscore profile. So this one is executed now, but let's try to see if I exit this server and I will again take the putty session for this server, and let me again put this session to the capture screen. Okay, yep, great. And I have to take this session again. I will close it and I will again put it to the session Oracle. Yep, let's wait for it to ask us for the password. Okay, yep, so we just entered the password. So yeah, earlier we had to set the environment in order to take the SQL plus session for that particular database. Okay, and what was the database name which is running? So DBorg is our database. So this time let's see if we are able to login. Yep, see, how come we are able to login this time? Because if I do cat bash underscore profile, these lines we earlier saved into this file, and as I told, whenever we login from that particular OS user, and this file is present under this OS user or home, so this file will automatically execute, and whatever content is under this file it will set. So what it did when we login again onto the server, this file executed and it set all this environment automatically. So this kind of thing help when we know we are having this particular database running on the server, and we have to do daily maintenance or daily monitoring or daily task onto that particular database, onto that server. So this thing helps us to ease our work. Okay guys, that's for this current session. We'll see you in next video. Thanks.